What is going on, guys? Tiger here with Tiger Uppercut Media. Thank you so much for joining me for another Dokkan battle video today. So, since the response to my Optimal Realm of Gods category team video was very positive, I decided to come back and make another one for the Hybrid Saiyans category. Now, the Hybrid Saiyans category is widely considered by a lot of people to be the Whale category. And the reason for that is quite simple. There are actually three summonable LRs on the most optimal team. So for that reason, most people aren't going to be able to run the most optimal Hybrid Saiyans team. But nonetheless, even a not 100% optimal Hybrid Saiyans team is still quite strong. So what we're going to be doing today is starting with the best possible team first. And at the end of the video, I'll be providing some top alternates so that you guys can still make the best possible team for you based on your available units. And for global players, the optimal team actually isn't even possible because we're missing some of those units. So you guys definitely want to stay until the end of the video so they can find top replacements for those unavailable cards. Just one disclaimer before I start is that this optimal team is based on my personal opinion and my personal knowledge of the game. If you have a different view on what the optimal Hybrid Saiyans team is, that's totally cool, and I can completely respect that. Now, without further ado, let's get to it. Obviously, number one, as your leader, you want Strength Ultimate Gohan. He is a very strong unit, but not really mind-blowing, so I guess a lot of people don't give him the credit I think that he personally deserves. His leader skill is Hybrid Saiyans, Ki plus 3, HP and defense plus 170%, and attack plus 130%. So the really exciting thing is that he is the first leader on Global with a 170% boost to stats, but the extra boost to HP and defense is offset by a lower attack buff. So since attack is the most impactful stat in Dokkan, this leader skill actually is a little bit weaker in my opinion than Omega Shenron and SDF or Gogeta and some of those other 150% leaders. His passive is attack plus 120%, and Super Kai allies defense plus 50%, with a medium chance to activate guard against all types, which translates to 30%. So yeah, he is a great unit, there's no doubt about that, but he just doesn't really have that wow factor, you know what I mean? Next, moving on, we have LR Gohan. He is the hardest hitting unit in the entire game. I think that's enough said. He demolishes everything. If you are lucky enough to have him, use it. Use him. That's all I'm gonna say. Next is LR Trunks. And of course, he's not currently available on Global, although I do expect him to drop very soon, maybe within the next couple weeks. He is a very hard hitter, as in summonable LR. Obviously, they all are hard hitters. But he also has that built-in crit on his passive. So even if you have zero orbs invested in his potential system, he still has a 50% chance to crit every single turn. One thing that a lot of people don't actually know about him is that he is also a very solid tank because he gets a 30% defense buff every time he supers. Moving on, we got LR, Goten, and Trunks. Again, they are very hard hitters and they're also self-sufficient by providing their own key with their passive. If that's not reason enough for you, they also have a really cool super attack mechanic with the various transformations from skinny tanks to fat tanks all the way to SSJ3. So overall, it's just a very fun unit to play with. Now we got two more. We have physical SSJ3 Gotenks, who is the hardest hitting TUR in the game. So he just does a crap load of damage. That's all you really need from him, and he does it very, very well. And last but not least, this might be a little bit of a weird one for some people, Beerus. So Beerus is actually not even in the Hybrid Saiyans category, so he's not gonna get that 170% or 130% buff, but he's just too good to leave off the team. He is the best orb changer in the game. He changes both tech and int orbs to physical orbs. And his main role is to supply key to LR Gohan to ensure that he always gets his 18 or 24 key super off and just demolishes everything. So I believe that he is optimal on this team, but if you have a different opinion, like I said, totally cool. One funny thing I noticed actually is that Trunks actually shows up three times on this list. You got LR Trunks, obviously. He's part of LR Goten and Trunks. And he's also one half of S's J3 Gotenks. So honestly, I think they should have just gone one step further and made the leader of this category Trunks as well, because this is basically his team. Just a funny thing I noticed. But to recap, the most optimal team for Hybrid Saiyans at this point in time is obviously Strength Ultimate Gohan as leader, LR Gohan, LR Trunks, LR Goten and Trunks, Physical SSJ3 Gotenks, and Beerus. So if you have all those characters, congratulations. You have the optimal Hybrid Saiyans team and can probably crush everything in this game with no problem. But if you don't have the most optimal units, don't despair. Well, also, if you're a global player, don't despair. Here are some top alternatives that can still do some really awesome things on the Hybrid Saiyans team, even if they're not optimal. So we're gonna start with number one, Int Rage Trunks. And this guy is a orb changer. He also does pretty decent damage and links well with LR Trunks. So he will provide a lot of ki and some attack boost as well to LR Trunks. So overall, has a lot of uses and is a really solid unit. Next up is Physical Super Saiyan Gotenks. And this guy is a sealer, and he's the best sealer in the game because he's also a very hard hitter. So no other unit in this game really fills this role as well as this Super Saiyan Gotenks. So if you have him and you don't have one of the units that I listed as an optimal unit, definitely throw him on your team. This guy with like two or three dupes in him can actually crit for over 2 million. So still really, really solid. Next up, Tech SSJ3 Gotenks. And obviously this is an older god lead, but he's still really good. I know a lot of people have forgotten about him since Physical SSJ3 Gotenks came out, but if you don't have Physical SSJ3 Gotenks, Tech SSJ3 Gotenks is actually still a monster. With no dupes, my SSJ3 Gotenks, the tech version, actually crits for like up to 2 million, if you get his 11 key super off, that is. So he is still very good, so consider using him if you don't have the physical one. Moving on, we have Physical Kid Super Saiyan Trunks, another very hard hitter. And Strength Super Saiyan Trunks GT, also hits hard. So when I say hard hitter, I mean the unit has at least a 100% attack buff on their passive. So all these units at SA10 can easily hit for over a million, sometimes even up to 2 million with some orbs invested in them. Just a couple of supports here that can do really well on the team as well. We got Physical Super Saiyan Trunks. He gives all allies attack and defense plus 25%, and also is a really good linking partner for LR Trunks. Of course, doesn't really apply to you if you're on global, but if you're on the Japanese version of the game, then he is a really solid support for LR Trunks. Physical GT Pan. She gives all allies attack and defense plus 30%. And we got Physical SSJ2 Gohan. He is all allies, attack and defense plus 35%. And again, he is also exclusive to JP. But if I remember correctly, he's actually being dropped on global in just a few days from now. So just be patient, wait a couple days, and his Dokkan Awakening will come to global as well. So stay tuned for him. He is a really, really good support. Like I said, 35%. To all allies for attack and defense. So he's actually probably the best support on this list right here. And lastly, we have Int Pandel. So she gets all allies attack plus 30%. No defense buff, but still 30% is really solid. And if you don't have, you know, the ones I listed before, then consider using her as well. The cool thing about all these supports is that they are all also in the Hybrid Saiyans category. So they will get the 130 to 170% buff as well. So that's it, guys. Those are all the top alternates that will still be very, very strong on a Hybrid Saiyan team, even if you don't have all the optimal units that I listed. I hope you guys found the video very useful. And if you like the video, make sure to hit that like button and consider subscribing to the channel. Join the Tiger Squad today and stay tuned for more awesome Dokkan content and nerd content in general, just like this. Hope you guys have an awesome day. This was Tiger with Tiger Uppercut Media signing out.